B-Dub the Anime Master is back. Triple Pack English Dub Toonami Reviews. Intro start.
B-Dub the Anime Master. B-Dub the Anime Master. B-Dub the Anime Master. B-Dub the Anime Master.
Dragon Ball Z
the Anime One Master.
Here we go,
the Anime
Death
Master.
Nigga.
Dragon Ball Z
the Anime One Master.
Here we go.
So we are back for the English dub reviews for Toonami. Toonami English dub reviews. A quick note, I will be reviewing the Lupin the Third Blue Jacket series, the dub version, when it premieres on Toonami in about a week or so. So stay tuned for the Lupin the Third Blue Jacket series dub reviews as well. But right now, let's talk about Dragon Ball Super Episode 20 English dub. So, let me talk about the episode a little bit first, then I'll talk about the English dub cast over here. Brought to you by Xfinity, Comcast, whatever you want to call them. Not really, but I do need sponsorship. So the episode was kind of one-to-one ratio with the Resurrection F Frieza movie, and some of the dialogue, the English dub dialogue, was pretty much one-to-one, kind of the same, about 90% the same dialogue with a couple differences here and there. Some few new scenes like the Goten and Trunks stuff with Jocko and etc. But, you know, Frieza's been revived. They kept Taguma alive. Frieza just, you know, just shot him up and stuff. Because in the film version, he just, you know, blasts a hole in the ship and he disappears. That's because they changed some things for the Resurrection F Frieza arc. And you'll see what I'm talking about later if you haven't watched the subtitle version of Dragon Ball Super. But Frieza's back. Everybody's getting ready to fight Frieza's 1,000 soldiers. And Goku and Vegeta are still training with Whis on Beerus's planet. But there are a couple changes, so I'm going to be talking about that once we get into those, you know, differences and etc., you know, as the episodes continue. Anyway, a straightforward English dub episode. The dub script, like I said, was, you know, kind of the same as far as the Resurrection F film. New lines here and there, a couple new scenes, but it was pretty good, you know, a pretty good adaption English dub script. Now let's talk about the cast. Frieza, played by Christopher Ayers. I got the cast list on my television screen. Frieza, played by Chris Ayers, doing an amazing, fantastic job. He is just killing it, man. He sounds even better than ever as Frieza, and I can't wait to hear more of Chris Ayers as Frieza. Jocko, played by Todd Haberkorn, doing a good job playing that character. Pretty funny character. Bulma, Monica Rial, doing excellent. Sorbet, played by Jeremy Schwartz, doing an excellent job. Krillin, played by Sonny Strait, he was pretty good. Beerus, played by Jason Douglas. Whis, played by Ian Sinclair, doing an excellent job. Goku, played by Sean Schimmel, great job as well. The narrator, Doc Morgan, doing excellent. Alexis Tipton as Trunks, young Trunks. It seems that she's kind of making the role her own at this point. It doesn't sound too much like a voice match for Laura Bailey's Trunks. It actually sounds pretty good for what the voice she's trying to use for the character. So that's pretty exciting about that. So Alexis Tipton doing a great job being Trunks. Moving on, we have Goten, played by Kira Edwards, which was a great. Android 18, played by Meredith McCoy, doing a great job. Christopher R. Sabin as Vegeta. Takuma, played by Vika Solaside. Tien, John Bergmeier, Master Roshi, Mike McFarlane, Gohan, Kyle Aber, Piccolo, Christopher Sabin. Everybody did a great job as far as the dub cast is concerned. And we're going into the more interesting material, because Resurrection F Frieza arc for Dragon Ball Super do have some different stuff, but you know, it's kind of a rehash of the films like, you know, Battle of Gods and Resurrection F. And we won't get into the true new material until the Universe 6 stuff. I'm going to enjoy watching the Frieza stuff again, because it's, you know, Chris Ayers Frieza. It's always great, and it's always a treat to hear Chris Ayers play Frieza. And it's going to be pretty fun, you know. It's going to be fun when they do those differences and stuff, you know, the Goten and Trunks stuff and etc. So, like I said, a great dub, great episode. That's about it. Attack on Titan Season 2 English dub Episode 5 review. Toonami premiere, and this reveal, like all you dub only fans out there, this reveal for Attack on Titan was incredible. I watched the Japanese version a few weeks ago, and I couldn't wait to see this in dub form. Warning, spoilers, watch the episode first before you watch this review, because it's going to be major spoilers. The reveal of the Colossal Titan and the Armored Titan, Bertholdt and motherfucking Reiner. I was like, are you shitting me? Are you fucking kidding me? You know, it was just a fantastic reveal. And hearing the dub version was great. And Rod McCullum is the voice actor of the week for this dub episode. He fucking destroyed it. He killed the performance of Reiner. It was fucking great. Rod McCullum, voice actor of the week for this episode by far. I would say the second runner-up is Bryce Papenbrook as Aaron Yeager. We heard some more performance from Mikasa, played by Trina Nishimura, doing a great job. Armin, played by Josh Grayley, who was excellent. Bertolt, played by David Matranga, also doing a good job. Hanji, played by Jessica Carvello, who's also freaking amazing. We hear a little bit of Hanaz, played by David Wald. Everybody in this episode did a great job, but I had to get back to the reveal, the flashback, the back and forth, the revelation of the fact that Bertolt and Reiner are from the same village as Annie, and put two and two together, or two and three together, because three of them motherfuckers, and you get a great reveal. And the way the reveal was just laid out flat, like, I'm the Armored Titan, he's a Colossal Titan. It was just so like, well, hold on, did that just happen? I rewinded it. I'm like, did that just happen when I watched the original Japanese version? That was my reaction. I was like, hold on, did he just say that shit? No fucking way. And it's amazing how, you know, it's been almost 4 years since season one, and I don't read the manga for Attack on Titan. And it's pretty amazing that I haven't been spoiled about this particular reveal in like 4 years. I'm a beast when it comes to avoiding spoilers. From time to time, I sometimes get spoiled by Walking Dead shit, you know, the TV series, but I digress. But the reveal for the Armored Titan and the Colossal Titan was great. It was epic. It was amazing, and I can't wait to see how the dub does these next couple of episodes, because I'm still watching the current Japanese simulcast version of Attack on Titan Season 2, and I can't wait to hear and see how they play the next couple of scenes. Well, not just scenes, but full episodes in dub form. The dub so far has been fucking fantastic. English adaptation script is pretty damn good, very tight. I got some 1-1 ratio moments with a little bit of liberties, but it's not to the point where it's taken away from the story. But it's pretty damn good anyway, overall. So like I said, a fantastic dub episode. The reveal was fantastic. Aaron transforming. The battle's about to begin. I can't wait till next fucking Saturday. I can't wait. Anyway, let me know your thoughts on the Attack on Titan Season 2 Episode 5 dub episode. Hunter x Hunter 2011 Episode 53 English Dub Toonami Premiere Review. So, I'm looking at the English Dub cast list, the main cast of characters. Gon, played by Erica Mendez. Killua, played by Christina V. Karapika, played by Erica Harlicker. Leorio, played by Matt Mercer. All four did a great job. Excellent as always. It's gonna be, you know, it's gonna, you know what, I'm gonna say that because that's kind of a spoiler, but I really am enjoying the main cast, and I don't want to get into too many spoilers for you fans out there who probably don't watch the subtitle version of Hunter x Hunter. But you know, I'm gonna keep it dub only for you dub only fans out there. Anyway, Hisoka, played by Keith Silverstein, only had a few lines, but he was great as always. Silva, played by Chris Tergolafera, and Zeno, played by William Dokes. Those two are going to be the voice actors of the week for this episode because their performances was just fucking awesome. You know, last episode they were great, and this episode they were great as well. We hear Illumi again, played by Chris Hackney, who was very creepy and awesome. We hear, you know, some more side main characters. Melody, played by Dorothy Fahn. Zepa, played by Greg Chun. Neon, played by Faye Matta. Nostra, played by the great Bo Billingsley, all doing a great job. Great English dub performances. Zenji, played by Hank Ketchum, who also plays the narrator. Squala, played by Ray Chase. Basho, played by Jake Everall. Bean, played by Xander Mobus, all did an awesome job. The second voice actor of the week is Robbie Damon as Krollo, who is just straight beast mode, and a great, perfect English dub voice for the leader of the Phantom Troop. Shardnark, played by Griffin Burns. Phaeton, played by Tom Bauer. Finks, played by David Vincent. Franklin, played by Edward Bosco. And Shizuku, played by Janice Roman Roku, all turned in some awesome performances for this episode. A lot of main characters and a lot of cast members in episode 53 of Hunter x Hunter. And we heard a new Phantom Troop member, Kortopi, played by Tony Oliver. Had a few lines there, but it was a scratchy tone of his Sana Yamada voice from Tenchi Muyo GXP. But it was a good performance. Episode was great. For you Double Only fans out there, Karapika is now in a state of nothingness because he thinks the Phantom Troop members are all dead, and they really aren't. And Hisoka tried to, you know, throw him a bone and say, hey man, they're not dead, we played y'all. And I like how the Phantom Troop has switched the items. They made, you know, Kotobi made like a fake version of each item so they can get the money. I assume they got the money too. And, you know, keep the real items and then, you know, give the fake ones away to the auction, which was brilliant and awesome. I can't wait for the upcoming episodes. It's going to get even more interesting and beast mode. So stay tuned for you English dub fans out there for Hunter x Hunter. It ain't over yet. Karapika, it's not over yet. But it was a great episode. I'm going to, like I said, I mentioned this a few weeks ago. I'm going to try to do a live reaction or at least record my reactions watching the dub version. So let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. What are your thoughts on the Hunter x Hunter 2011 Dragon Ball Super and Attack on Titan Season 2 English Dub Reviews Toonami Premieres? Check out my Facebook fan page, leave a like, and follow me on Twitter. Leave a like for the video if you like anime as well. I'm B-Dub, the Anime Master. Peace.
Dragon Ball Z, the anime master. Here we go, the anime master. Dragon Ball Z, the anime master. Here we go.